Welcome to another Lightblade Learning Lab. Today, for a change, it's not going to be very technical, it's not going to be very difficult, and it's not going to be very long. If you remember the last time we had a session, I pointed out that this keyboard here was getting a little bit tacky, and I needed to protect it, as I had done on my other machine over there. And so what I've done, I've been away and I've designed a keyboard protection scheme for this particular machine. Now, it's different than the style that I used on my China Blue machine, but the essence of it is exactly the same. We've got a little flexible plastic film here which is going to cover and protect the keys. Now, we'll go straight in and we'll start cutting the design that I've already prepared, and then we'll go through the manufacture of it and you can see how we fit it.
We're cutting this keyboard out of 3mm thick material, and I've got my air assist turned on, and I'm going to turn it roughly half off because I don't want too much air for cutting acrylic, just some. The two pieces that we need, just strip the plastic film off. Okay, so the first thing that I've got to do with this is to put an M5 tapped hole through there very easily, and I can do that with a tap wrench, or as you can see, I'm using a drill chuck. Now, I'm using that size. You can use any size you like, but I happen to use that size because I've got some very short M5 screws. They're 6mm long. And we're going to put that piece there, like that. And then we're going to put this piece here, like this. I hold the two pieces together. With a screw, like that. So now we've got an invisible cover sitting on the top there. At the moment, there's nothing in there, but what I'm going to do, I've got, I think it's probably polyester film, and it's about 0.2, 0.25 millimeters thick, and it's the sort of thing that you get on a presentation box. This came off a box of Christmas cards, and I was sensible enough at Christmas to think, I might have a use for that, and I kept it. So that will be my protective film that's going to sit underneath this keyboard frame that I've produced here. And the frame can't go anywhere because it's locked around these two buttons that we've got here. So the positions of the buttons on your machine might be different, but hey, it's the idea that you need, and I shall put this DXF file onto the Thinklaser website so that you can use it as a basis for starting your own keyboard protection. Right, now I've kept this the correct way round when I've taken it off, because what we're going to do now is to apply to the back of it some double-sided industrial strength tape. Now, this is Taser 4965, which is a very high bond strength industrial tape. Now I'm going to stick it round the outside of the frame there. Okay, now it's a matter of trimming it off neatly all the way round. Well, there's that double-sided tape on there. So now we've got to peel that off. Right, so there's a double-sided tape peeled off, but I haven't cut the hole in at this moment in time. That's going to be a little bit tricky, so I'll leave that till after I've attached this. So we might as well just pop this on flat, like this. Attach it on nice and strongly. Get rid of all the air bubbles. Okay, So as you can see, it's not difficult to do this. It trims out very easily with a knife. Okay, so I've just cleared that hole out with a drill and we're all ready to go. So the first thing I'm going to do is to make the keyboard like new by peeling off the protective films. And there it is, back to absolutely pristine condition. We shall now pop this on. Whoops, wrong way. We'll pop that on. And we'll put the screw in. And if and when it gets a bit mucky, well, next Christmas you can get another piece of film and make a new one. Well, this is definitely the star of the show today, but I thought I'd try and get in on the act as well, just so that I could say cheerio and I'll see you next time.